For the next couple of examples, let's just consider all natural numbers from 1 to 10. In other words, let's make our universal set 1 through 10. And let's say we have a set A, and A includes the following numbers. For our first new concept, let's talk about the complement of A. This is denoted as A with a prime on it. Sometimes we might denote it as an A with a C for complement on it. Either way, what the complement of A is the set of all elements that are not in A. So for this example, A complement is going to be all of the numbers between 1 and 10 except for 3, 4, 5, and 8. So A complement includes 1, 2, 6, 7, 9, and 10. We can visualize sets by drawing a Venn diagram. And a Venn diagram typically is a rectangle representing our universal set U and circles representing our sets. In this example, A contains the elements 3, 4, 5, and 8. Outside of A, somewhere the elements 1, 2, 6, 7, 9, and 10. Now I kind of scattered my elements all over the place, but you could have just as easily drawn a more ordered looking Venn diagram that would mean the exact same thing. For example, something like this would be the exact same Venn diagram. Now, as we always do in math, why don't we complicate this situation a little bit? Let's start with the same universal set and the same set for A, but let's add in a set B. And let's say the elements in B are 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Now you'll notice that there are elements in A that are not in B, there are elements in B that are not in A, and there is some overlap between these two sets. There are some elements that are in both A and B. So if this is the case, our Venn diagram is going to look something like this. We have a set A, and we have a set B, and there is some overlap between those two sets. The overlap between these two sets is the elements 3 and 5. Also in set A are the elements 4 and 8, and in set B, but not in set A, are the elements 1, 7, and 9. Now still out here in the universal set, outside of both A and B, are the elements 2, 6, and 10. Now earlier we introduced the concept of a complement and decided that the complement of A was this right here. We could also find the complement of B. All of the elements that are not in B are. Now let's introduce this concept of an intersection. Down here we could see that the sets A and B intersect, and that intersection between those two sets includes the elements 3 and 5. We have notation for this intersection. The intersection of A and B is denoted with this intersection symbol right here in between A and B. And this new set includes all of the elements that are both in A and B. In our example, the intersection of A and B includes the elements 3 and 5. And as a note, it is pretty common for us to think of this symbol right here as meaning and. So we define the intersection operation between sets. Now let's define the union. The union of A and B is denoted with this right here, basically a U in between A and B. And the union of A and B includes all elements that are in A or in B or in both sets. In our example, A union B, I'll try to write them in order, is going to include the elements 1, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 9. Those are all of the elements that are in either A or B, or in both. And as another note, this union sign here, we often think of as an or. Now, why don't I zoom out a little bit to make a little bit of space, and we can do a few more examples. What if I asked you to find A union B complement? Well, what this notation means is, we need to find the union of A and B first, and then take the complement of that. Well, we found A unioned with B right here. So the complement of this set is everything that's not in this set, which is just 2, 6, and 10. Let's make up another example. Let's say I wanted you to find A complement intersected with B. Well, what we would need to do is we would need to find A complement, we would need to make sure we have B, and then we would look at the intersection of those two sets. Fortunately, above, we already have A complement written out. It includes the elements 1, 2, 6, 7, 9, and 10. We also have B written out, and that includes the elements 1, 3, 5, 7, and 9. Now, the intersection of those two sets is all of the elements that are in both sets. That would be 1, 7, and 9. Okay, and you could imagine I could probably come up with any number of increasingly complicated looking intersections and unions of sets. But I do want to introduce one or two more concepts to you. The difference between two sets is given by A minus B. This would be the set of all elements that belong to A but don't belong to B. Well, we could do this problem just by looking at sets A and B, or we could look at the Venn diagram. It's easier for me to visualize this by looking at the Venn diagram. All of the elements that belong to A but don't belong to B are included in this piece of the Venn diagram right here. Those are the elements 4 and 8. So our set A minus B is the set 4, 8. Okay, just a couple more thoughts and I'll let you go. Let's recall the notation for the cardinal number of a set. N of A, that just means the number of elements in A. And if we look over here at A, we see that A has 4 elements. The number of elements in B, you can see, is 5. Let's go down here and look at the number of elements in A and B, or A intersected with B. And we see from this set that we have 2 elements. One more, let's look at the number of elements in A union B. We can see from this set that there are 7 elements in the union of A and B. Now, if we look at this Venn diagram, the intersection of A and B is in this little area right here. The union of A and B can be given by all of the elements in this whole region right here. So this formula is going to look a little bit complicated, but it's probably not too surprising that the number of elements in A unioned with B, that's the number of elements in this region up here, should be the number of elements in A plus the number of elements in B. But notice when we add the number of elements in A and the elements in B together, we get some overlap in the middle. We've counted these middle two elements, or these intersection elements, twice. So what we need to do to get the number of elements in this whole region A unioned with B is we need to subtract off the number of elements in the intersection of A and B. And if you look at the numbers for our particular example here, you see that we get 7 equals 4 plus 5 minus 2, and that is a true statement. So this formula checks out. Okay, I think that's all I have for you for an introduction to complements and unions and intersections. I hope that helps you out, and I will see you next time.